May I say to you, as I prepare to go back to the deep south, and to the dark and desolate moments of Alabama with all of its difficulties still ahead, I have faith in the future, and I have faith in America, and I believe we're going to solve this problem. I believe that we are developing a coalition of conscience that will mobilize itself on a continuing basis to the point of bringing about a solution. I believe that somehow and in some way we shall overcome before the victory is won. Some of us will get scarred up a little. Before the victory is won, some more will be thrown into jail. Before the victory is won, some will be called bad names, misunderstood. Some will be called Reds and Communists simply because they believe in the brotherhood of man. Before the victory is won, somebody else may have to face physical death. If physical death is the price that some must pay to free their children from a permanent death of the spirit, then nothing can be more redemptive. Yes, we shall overcome. We are not afraid. The Lord will see us through, and we shall overcome because the arc of the universe is long, but it bends toward justice. We shall overcome because Carlyle is right. No lie can live forever. With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mounting of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to speed up that glad and bright day when all of God's children all over this nation, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, "Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last." Thank you.